of all the characters, he's had like the most transition over the course of season one.
Yeah.
How does he evolve in season two?
Well, we start from where we left off in season one, obviously, which is he's not the hardened warrior that he was. And we're dealing with a future that is completely different from the one that Tiger and Wolf left. Mm-hmm. So it's a new fish out of water story. In a future that we thought we knew, but is completely different. So it's a matter of seeing what's different. And it is completely different from what we left. As opposed to living in the sewers, now everyone's above ground. And which is, and it's this great thing that, you know, they live above ground. Mm-hmm. And it's really not a pleasant place that they live. So there's a lot of adaptation. There's only two real food ingredients. So for Wolf, that's a challenge. But he adapts, as he always does. And
I'm hearing that. What I love about Wolf is the way he's so resilient.
Yeah.
And no matter what he sees, he just embraces it and really takes it on.
Yep.
And that's the most fun part of the whole show for me. So I'm wondering, what was the most fun for you to play? What aspect of Wolf?
Well,
I
love it when he finds something that is surprising to him and affects him in a way that's surprising. Like in this season, he finds love in various forms. And that was really fun to play because it's a surprising thing. And he goes, the thing is, he never goes halfway. He goes all the way. And everything else be damned, like, this is what I'm doing. Yeah. I think it was finding love was a fun thing to play with this season.
Can you discuss the trust between Tiger and Wolf?
The trust? It's challenged. You know, we start to find out at the end of season one, we the audience, the tiger is biotic, and so we start dealing with that through season two, and that's a big challenge. It's a pretty big strain on the relationship, because honor and trust are a huge thing to both. Two huge things to both. And you know, he really values honor and truth. And if you go against that, it's hard to talk about this too, because the thing is, we get so close in the show that there are a few scenes where I had to be pretty nasty. I had to get pretty nasty with Tiger because of this, and it's really emotional. It's really hard to do. I mean, it's not hard to do, but it's hard to do that to, you know, to Eliza and to Tiger. You know what I mean? But it's hopefully fun to watch and thrilling and all that stuff.
Is it hard for you to do the Wolf voice? Does it like hurt you?
It doesn't hurt me. It's hard to do in a setting like this.
Yeah.
But as soon as I get, we're in a scene, it just comes, it's just there. It only hurts if I have to project a lot. If it's like a big audience scene or something, I have to go back to my theater training and try to get into that, which is tough with the sort of throatiness of it. But yeah, I hurt myself only once, and that was in season one in the Trouble Dome. And that it was just too much. It was a long day and a lot of yelling. And it actually kind of works towards the end of the scene. You can hear my voice going out, and I'm just sort of over and tired, and it works. You know?
It's honestly like a really macho, hardened voice. Like, did you take inspiration from any characters in crafting it?
Oh, yeah. When I showed up, I've said this before, but I love it. When I showed up to do the pilot, I was brought on to do this like 2 days before we started shooting the pilot, because I was shooting Preacher with Seth and Evan. And so I came in and had really very little idea of what to do with this character, which you can see if you watch the very first pilot, but it's not fully formed yet. And Evan Goldberg came up to me and said, just for now, like, just try your best, like, macho Batman voice. And so it hasn't stayed there, but it's become a wolf, you know, wolf's voice, but that's where it started.
So at the beginning of season two, you guys are kind of separated. How was that for you to play without your cohorts there?
I missed them a lot. Yeah, we all missed each other. We text a lot, and, you know, we're just like, what did you do today? And, you know, it's, yeah. I think that's gonna, it's a nice thing to see us go on our own journeys, and grapple with our own issues. But yeah, for us as actors, we miss each other. And I think if hopefully we do a season three, that we'll be together more. Yeah, because we've done that grand experiment now.
Do you think it's possible that there's a future where both Wolf and Tiger are happy?
Yeah.
Because it kind of seems like it's one or the other right now.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, maybe season seven. yeah, why not? I think anything is possible. It's just a matter of, like, lining the right ducks up in a row to make that future happen. Because every little, as we see in season two, every little thing that we did in season one has affected this future. Yeah.
Do you have any, do you have any theories or, like, speculation of where you want to see the show go in season three?
I would like to go deeper into history. Where that is, I don't know. I mean, it'd be fun to go to, like, the Old West. If we're really following the Back to the Future thing. That would be a fun thing. Or, you know, prehistoric times, even. Yeah. I want to go back out of the 20th century. So, I want to wear really fabulous costumes. That's what I want. Yeah, that's what I want. Yeah.